When starting to build Slack modular apps, it's important to have a solid understanding of all the moving pieces. Today, we're going to talk about the manifest.ts file. While the app manifest is not a new concept for Slack apps, in modular apps, the app manifest takes on a whole new meaning. Let's take a look. By now, you've installed the Slack CLI onto your machine. You'll want to run the Slack create command and select the Hello World template from the options provided. Now we can open the app in a code editor to see what the directory structure looks like. Locate the manifest.ts file. It may not look like much, but don't let that fool you. The manifest.ts file is at the core of the modular app's nervous system. So what are we looking at? The manifest.ts file is the centralized place for your app's configuration. The manifest object contains basic information about your app, such as its name and description, which are then exported so that the properties can be used throughout the app. The manifest.ts file also contains information about the more functional components of your app. You'll notice there's a workflows property that lists all the workflows your app will use, and a bot scopes property that defines all the permissions your app will need to run on a workspace. As you build out your app, you can also add properties like functions, outgoing domains, and data stores. For a full list of the manifest object properties, you can reference the documentation linked below. The app manifest makes it easy for developers to understand, change, and share app templates that can be run and installed on any workspace. Not bad. Now let's see what we can do from the CLI. The Slack CLI has a manifest command that you can use at any time during development. The Slack manifest command will generate the contents of your manifest from your local app in a raw JSON format. The Slack manifest validate command will send your manifest to JSON generated from the previous command to the Slack API to be validated. This command will help you detect and warn you about any breaking changes. Moving forward on each local run or deploy, the CLI will update your manifest on the Slack API. This is helpful when troubleshooting instances in which your manifest might be failing to update. Validating the manifest will help you confirm whether your manifest is in good shape before saving a work file. That's it for today's video. I hope you found it helpful. To learn more about Slack modular apps, make sure to watch our other videos. And as always, we want to hear your feedback, so please let us know what you think about modular apps and the Slack API in the comments below, or send us a tweet over here. Bye!